Hello everyone. First, let's clarify what Nobara Project is and what it is not. Nobara Project is not a Fedora spin, which means that it's not an official variation of Fedora Linux created by the Fedora team. Instead, Nobara Project is an independent project that uses Fedora packages, codes, and repository as a base, but adds its own modifications, fixes, and packages to enhance the overall user experience. Think of it as a remix or a custom version of Fedora that targets a specific audience. So, what does Nobara Project offer that Fedora Linux does not? Several features and additions that are not included in the regular Fedora distribution. For example, Nobara Project includes Wine dependencies already added, which allows users to run Windows applications and games on Linux. It also includes third-party codec packs for GStreamer, which enables better multimedia playback and streaming support. Additionally, Nobara Project comes with NVIDIA drivers already built in, which can be useful for users with NVIDIA graphics card who want to maximize their performance. But that's not all. Nobara Project also includes various fixes and improvements that aim to make Fedora Linux more user-friendly and easier to use, especially for beginners who are not familiar with the command line. For instance, Nobara Project includes a good number of miscellaneous packages that can be useful for various purposes such as web browsing, document editing, and media production. Among the pre-installed software, we can find Proton, Discord, Steam, Lutris, MangoHood, plus Gavorlay, plus Gamescap, OBS Studio, and the only Office Suite, to name a few. Another aspect that makes Nobara Project stand out is its focus on gaming, streaming, and content creation. For example, it includes Proton, a compatibility tool that enables thousands of Windows games to run on Linux with minimal hassle. It also includes MangoHood, a tool that overlays useful information on top of games such as FPS, GPU, and CPU usage, temperatures, and more. Additionally, Nobara Project includes Gamescap, a compositor that reduces latency and input lag while improving performance and visuals. These tools can help gamers and streamers to have a better experience on Linux, which is not always known for its gaming capabilities. Now that we know what Nobara Project offers, let's see how to get started with it. First, you need to visit the official website of Nobara Project, which is nobaraproject.org. Once there, you can go to the download section and choose the version of Nobara Project that suits your needs. Currently, there are three versions available. The Workstation Edition, which includes GNOME as the default desktop environment, the KDE Edition, which includes KDE Plasma as the default desktop environment, and the Server Edition, which is designed for servers and comes with a minimal installation. Once you have downloaded the ISO image of the version you want, you can create a bootable USB drive or DVD using a tool such as Balena Etcher or Rufus. Then you can boot your computer from the USB drive or DVD and follow the installation wizard. The installation process should be similar to the one of Fedora Linux, with some minor differences related to the customization edition of Nobara Project. After the installation is complete, you should have a fully functional Nobara Project system with all the features and additions mentioned earlier. You can customize it further according to your preferences. Proton and Lutris. With the inclusion of Proton and Lutris, users can run a large number of Windows games and applications on Linux. Proton is a compatibility layer that allows users to play Windows games on Linux by utilizing Wine, while Lutris is a gaming platform that makes it easier to manage and launch games on Linux. Improved multimedia support. Nobara Project comes with third-party codec packs for GStreamer, which provides better support for multimedia playback in various formats. This means that users don't need to worry about installing additional codecs to play their favorite media files. NVIDIA drivers included. NVIDIA is one of the most popular graphics card manufacturers, and their drivers are essential for playing games and running graphic-intensive applications. Nobara Project comes with NVIDIA drivers pre-installed, making it easier for users to get up and running with the NVIDIA graphics card. Only Office. Nobara Project comes with Only Office, an open-source office suite that provides users with a range of applications for creating and editing documents, spreadsheets, and presentations. This is a great alternative to Microsoft Office, and it's completely free to use. WayDroid support. WayDroid is a project that allows users to run Android apps on Linux. Nobara Project includes an update App Armor DNS Mask profile that allows the use of WayDroid, making it easier for users to run their favorite Android apps on Linux. Improved desktop experience. Nobara Project comes with GNOME or KDE Plasma, two popular desktop environments that provide users with a modern and intuitive interface. Additionally, the project includes a range of fixes and improvements that makes the overall desktop experience smoother and more polished. Overall, Nobara Project is a great choice for users who want to get up and running with Linux quickly and easily. With its focus on gaming, streaming and content creation, it provides users with a range of tools and applications that makes it easier to get started with these activities on Linux. Additionally, with its improved multimedia support, NVIDIA drivers and OnlyOffice, it provides users with a comprehensive and user-friendly operating system that is suitable for a wide range of tasks. If you're looking to switch to Linux, Nobara Project is definitely worth checking out. If you find this video useful, please like, share and subscribe.